Hi, in this video I am going to discuss about phylum Platyhelminthes. Let us discuss about some of the general characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. The members of the Platyhelminthes are generally dorso-ventrally flattened. That's why they are called as flatworms. The members of Platyhelminthes are commonly called as flatworms because their body is dorso-ventrally flattened. Ventrally flattened. Mostly the members of Platyhelminthes are endoparasites. And they are found in animals, including human beings. The members of the phylum Platyhelminthes are bilaterally symmetrical. Triploblastic. Acinomate. And having organ level of organization. So, the members of the phylum Platyhelminthes are generally bilaterally symmetrical. That is, their body can be divided into two equal halves by dividing them through any one of the plane passing through the central axis. And they are triploblastic organisms, that is, they are having three embryonic germ layers, that is, ectoderm and endoderm and mesoderm in between both of endoderm and ectoderm. They are acoelomate organisms, that is, they don't have any cavity in between the body wall and the gut wall, and they have organ level of organization, that is, specialized organs are present in them which perform some of the specified function, that for each specified function each organ is responsible. So these are some of the general characteristics of the phylum Platyhelminthes. Digestion in the members of Platyhelminthes is both intracellular and extracellular. The sexes are not separate, that is, they are hermaphrodite organisms. They are hermaphrodite organisms, that is, the sperms and the eggs are produced by the same individual only. Fertilization is internal. And there is a special kind of cells which are present in the members, which are called as the flame cells, which perform the function of both osmoregulation and excretion. Both these vital functions are performed by some of the specialized cells which are called as flame cells. Osmoregulation is the process by which water level maintains in the body, and excretion is the process of the removal of the wastage from the body. So these cells perform both these functions. Hooks and suckers. Hooks and suckers are the specialized structures which are present in some of the members, which are generally parasitic. In the parasitic forms, these hooks and suckers are present. fertilization, which is internal. Development is indirect. Through mini larval stages. Some of the members of Platyhelminthes, for example Planaria, possesses a well developed regeneration capacity. They have got a well-developed regeneration capacity. The example is Planaria. Development is indirect, which is by mini larval stages, and the fertilization is internal and the sexes are separate. That is, they are hermaphrodite organisms. So these are some of the general characteristics of the phylum Platyhelminthes, and the members which are generally included in this phylum are Tinea, which is called as a tapeworm, or liver fluke, which is called as fasciola. Tinea, which is called as tapeworm, or liver fluke, which is called as fasciola. These are some of the examples of the members of phylum Platyhelminthes. So in this video we have discussed about some of the general characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes, that these organisms are commonly called as flatworms and they are bilaterally symmetrical, having organ level of organization. They are acoelomate and triploblastic organisms, and the fertilization is internal. Sexes are not separate, they are hermaphrodite. And the development is indirect by mini larval stages. So these are some of the unique characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. In our next video, we will discuss about the phylum Eschihelminthes. So for more videos, visit www.excelclasses.com. Thanks.